Welcome to Vinix Studio. Let's start making games. Hi and welcome. In this video, we are going to see how to add a component using script. Now the component can be anything from a collider to rigid body or another script. In our scene, we have a cube with a box collider. So we'll remove the box collider from the cube. Then we have a move script attached to it. We'll use that script to add a box collider when the game starts. So let's click here and go to edit script. This will open the script in Visual Studio. Now I have an empty script here. In order to add a component, you have to use add component. The reason the autofill is not working is because you are not specifying where to add the component. So there is a variable. There is an object called this. Now this refers to this script. Now this dot game object. So we want to add the collider to the script's game object. So this dot game object dot add component. And you need to open close arrows and open close braces. Now inside the arrow, you need to give your component. So in our case, that's a box collider. And the statement ends with a semicolon. So adding a component is this simple. Let's save the script and go back to Unity. Let's run the game and see whether the box collider is added on game start. So now there is no box collider attached to the cube. I play the game. And you can see a box collider is added to the cube. Say you have another 3D object here. And we'll remove the sphere collider of it. Go to the cube. Now if you want to add the sphere collider from the script which is attached to the cube, you need to reference the sphere object. Now there are two ways to do it. One is to find the game object that is available in the hierarchy, and the other option is to use a public variable. We'll go about finding a game object in a different tutorial. So in this case, we'll use a public game object. So when you declare a game object as public, you will write the keyword public here, and then you will give the type of variable. So it's a game object, and then you will give the variable name. So let's call it sphere. So when you declare a public variable like this, it appears on the editor screen. For example, when you select the cube, you can see the public game object here. So now what you can do is you can just drag and drop the sphere here. So now you assign the sphere directly. So the script doesn't have to search for the game object during the gameplay because you already assigned it to it. So once that is done, instead of using this dot game object, we already have a game object. So that is sphere. So we'll go to sphere dot add component, and we don't need a box collider. We need a sphere collider. Sphere collider. So let's save the script, go back to Unity. In our script attached to the cube, we have already assigned the sphere, and in the sphere there is no sphere collider. So when I play the game, the sphere collider gets added. So this way you can add components to other game objects also. Now let's see how to remove a component. Let's delete the sphere from here, go to cube, add the box collider, and we'll modify our script to remove this box collider when the game starts. So you don't require this public game object. Other than transform, if you want to access any other component in the game object, you need to reference it first. So for example, we need to reference the box collider. So we have to create a variable of type box collider. We'll call it call. Then in the start function, you need to get the collider from the list of components. To do that, you have to use get component. And component name. Now to delete it, or remove it, you have to destroy it. So there's a function called destroy, and inside destroy you have to give the object that you want to destroy. So now what we are doing is we are referencing the box collider using a variable called call, getting the component into the variable and then destroying it. Here we know for sure that box collider exists, otherwise this will get a null object and you'll get an error that's trying to destroy a null object. So in general case, we'll be checking whether the box collider is available and whether call is not null. So for this tutorial and for simplicity, we'll just keep it as it is. So now our script is loaded and the box collider is attached to the cube. And when we play the game, the box collider is removed. That's it for this tutorial. In the next tutorial, we'll see how to import assets into Unity. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and share.